If a father kills his own son in self-defense, then sets the bones in a calabash gourd, the bones will turn to fish. And if the bowl breaks, the water will fill the valleys.
The album's called Time. Time being the thing that holds us all together, the glue that holds us all together.
Roots in the sky and branches in the sea.
But your divinities and cosmology.
When we were recording the album, it was very obvious that time, the concept of time, was one of the main concerns we had. Were we going to finish this album in time? Were we going to take 5 days and record 11 tracks? There was this pressure of time. And I remember Michelle saying, you know, don't even think about time. We're operating outside of time. Let's operate outside of time.
They knew that if you threw a stone from Sierra Leone, it would bloom into islands. They knew the sea. So they traveled by reed to reach the Haitian coast, seeking the gold in the rivers and the nicotine.
It's my fifth album, first solo album without the Spasm Band.
Searching for that paradise of the West. In the times of Ramesses.
Time was produced by Michelle and Diego Cello, and it was recorded in Paris at QDS. From the time that we said we were going to do it, we got our managers involved, and I think Antoine Rajon and Frank de Colonges as well from Heavenly Sweetness, they're the guys that really kind of pulled the whole project together. You know, me and Michelle were talking in a sort of artistic level, but they were sort of maneuvering the sort of business side of things together to make it work.
On a décidé de prendre le risque et de tout faire pour réussir à faire cet album, parce qu'on sentait qu'il y avait voilà, une vraie volonté d'Anthony, que surtout l'idée sur le papier était géniale, hein, entre voilà, un poète originaire de Trinidad qui vit à Londres et puis une musicienne productrice américaine archi douée. Donc les deux univers en plus, on sentait qu'elle allait bien se marier. Et on s'est dit, allez, let's go, on met un peu comme au casino tout l'argent qu'on a sur la table pour réussir à financer cet album. Et d'ailleurs, on a fait une campagne de crowdfunding pour demander aux fans de nous aider à financer ce disque, parce que sans eux, sans les fans, on n'aurait jamais pu le faire.
She was a black whip of a woman, had a look that kissed the silver edges of razors and blazed with hips that were...
Michelle and I started sending tracks when everything looked like it was really going to happen. We started sending ideas to each other, and she would send me little snippets of music, you know, 30 seconds of a song, a minute of a bit of music, and I would put words to it, find words to it, and send her the words, and that went on back and forth for a good few months. So we kind of worked on it by email, and by you know, sending each other files online. That went on for months.
Et l'enregistrement, il s'est passé quelque chose d'assez magique, parce qu'on avait fait en sorte que tout se passe bien, mais c'était vraiment sous ses faits en 5 jours. Les timings étaient vraiment serrés. On récupérait les musiciens en fin de tournée, donc ils étaient un peu crevés. Mais Michelle avait vraiment super bien fait les choses. Elle avait en fait tout l'album dans son ordinateur, des maquettes qui déjà mais sonnaient super bien rien que sur son ordinateur. Et en fait, pendant leur tournée, donc la tournée de Michel et de son groupe, tous les soirs, ils répétaient un titre. C'est-à-dire que c'était un peu scolaire. Tous les soirs, elle prenait les musiciens, elle leur disait, bah voilà, le titre, ça va être comme ça, comme ça, comme ça. Et du coup, ils sont arrivés, on a fait l'album à Paris, chez Question de Son, un nouveau studio, on ne connaissait pas non plus. Et en fait, tout s'est bien passé. Le studio était génial, l'équipe mortelle, et surtout, voilà, Michelle, elle a insufflé une énergie dans l'enregistrement qui était incroyable. Et le résultat était carrément au-delà de nos espérances.
Dark seed of her skin like tamarind. She was the kind of woman that made time stand still.
One of the more interesting things that happened in this in the recording of this album was there's a couple of tracks that actually, you know, what would happen is Michelle would ask me to send her a cappellas of the poems. So There's a couple of tracks that I sent a cappellas for, Tamarind, one of them, and for Women Who Wish Hair. I sent the a cappellas of these tunes, and when we were recording it in the studio, doing this, the proper recordings of it, the vocals that I did on the phone were the ones that sat in the music the best, and we ended up using the actual takes from the iPhone that was recorded on the iPhone at home, sitting in my living room, you know. So I thought that was quite interesting, but they were the ones that had the particular feeling and a particular sound that she wanted to capture. That was quite interesting.